So, at last we have come to step 12. Bas, abhi graduate ho jayenge hum log. So, step 1, powerless and unmanageable. When can I do it? As soon as I want to get well. Step 2, insanity, page 23, 24, 30. Belief, page 51, Columbus and Wright brothers. Power, page 46, 47. When can I take the step? As soon as you say you believe or are willing to believe. Step 3, made a decision to turn my will, that's thinking and actions, life, over to the care of God as I understand you. When can I do that? Page 60. Being convinced of what? Of 1 and 2. When can I do step 4? Page 63 at the bottom. It said next. We start on a personal inventory, which we should do at once. When can I do step 5? That is on page 75. They said when our inventory is done, we waste no time. Call the sponsor, get no proper volume. Can you guys hear me? Rachna is complaining that there's no proper volume.
Volume seems to be okay.
Okay, let me put the fan off. Okay, this might be a little better. So step 5, page 75, we waste no time. We go and tell our sponsor everything. There are two fifth steps. One is on page 73 where we tell our whole life story. The other is on page 75 where we share the fourth step inventory with the sponsor. Then what do we do after that step? We sit for 1 hour and we meditate and we revise step 1 to 5. Have we done everything properly? Step 6, when do we do that? They said, if when we answer the questions to our satisfaction, the 1 hour meditation questions, what do we do? Look at our defects. Where did we find them? Step 4. Do we want to keep any? God, please make me willing to have them removed. What about the rest? Are you ready to have them removed? Next paragraph. When ready, ask God to remove them. 7-step prayer. But those defects have a nasty habit of coming back. So I say that prayer every morning. When do I do step 8? They said now. What do? Make a list of all people I want. I have to make another list? No, I already have the list. I made it in step 4. So now what I'm going to do is go down my fourth step, resentments, sex and harms, and see whom do I owe amends, all of them. Do I make the amends right now? Maybe a little later. Maybe I'm not sure. Definitely not going to make it. Write them down. When do I do step 9? They said immediately. Now we go out to clean out the past. And they gave us different kind of amends. Most difficult amends first. The people who hate us and the people whom we hate. Next is money amends. Third is criminal amends. Three types of criminal amends. Petty theft, adding the expense account. Little more serious crime, not paying for alimony and back payment and stuff. Even more serious crime where the guy robbed money from someone else. What do you do? Clean up to the best as you can without going to jail. But it's between you and God. The guy with the most serious crime, he prayed and he said, I can't go to meet God without clearing my conscience. And he went. And he was amazed. When do you do step 10? On page 84. It says, while we are doing step 9. And step 10, continue to watch for resentful, fear, selfishness, dishonesty, which is step 4. When these defects crop up, step 6, we ask God at once to remove them, step 7. Discuss them with someone quickly, maybe by text message, that's step 5. And make amends quickly if we have done harm, that's step 8 and 9. Then we turn our thoughts to someone else we can help, that is step 11 and 12. So they are preparing us for that. Step 10, our sanity comes back. Recoil for height, fear, not temper, it's amazing. Then we came to 11. They said, 11, what to do at night? I wonder, how many of you people who are listening tonight actually did the 11 step via the big book last night? I'm just going to put on the participants for a minute. And whoever did the 11 step last night, after we finished this meeting, please raise your hands. Only Anish. And me. Wow. Only two of us.
I can't raise my hand as host.
Okay, three of us. Alwyn did the. Ash did it. Okay, very good. I'm so glad that the steps are so effective. Ah, Rijik, Ashok ji. Very good. Now the numbers are growing. Okay, how many of you did the 11th step this morning? Anybody? Ah, many more hands. KG, Arun, Christopher, Ash. Oh, now the numbers are coming. Hello. Okay. How many were not sure or doubtful and called their sponsor instead of calling God today? Page 86. When you are not sure what to do, we ask God. Call your sponsor after you get an answer. So anyway, I'm just having a little fun. Thanks for playing and putting up your hands. But it's a really simple program. You don't have to memorize anything. Open the big book and answer the questions. So that was step 11. And on the last paragraph on page 88 of the big book. One second. My big book is not next. Page 88, last paragraph. We alcoholics are undisciplined. So we let God discipline us in the simple way that we have just outlined. But this is not all. There is action and more action, not discussion. Faith without works is dead. Because if Columbus did not get in the trip boat and go on a second trip, where's the faith? If the Wright brothers did not build a second plane after the first plane crashed, where is the faith? If I did not go back to AA after a relapse, where is my faith that AA works? Faith without works is dead. The next chapter is entirely devoted to step 12. So step 12 says, having had a spiritual awakening or personality change, as the result of these steps, we try to carry this message to alcoholics and practice these principles in all our affairs. So there are multiple things over there. What is a spiritual awakening? It's a psychic change, it's a personality change, it's an emotional displacement, it's a transformation, it's a revolutionary change, it's an educational change. There's 12 or 13 different terms that they have used to describe what kind of change we have in Appendix 2. And we try to carry this message. What is this message? Go for meetings every day? No, that's not the message. The message is, alcoholism is an illness. Who told us this? Dr. Silkworth. Who has confirmed it? World Health Organization. Who else has confirmed it? Every doctor in every country in the world. It's in the medical book. So it's an illness. Okay? What is the treatment for this illness? The best treatment is the 12 steps. You can do it in an AA meeting. You can do it at home reading a book. You can go to a rehab center, a treatment center, recovery center, do it over there, doesn't matter. But that is the best and most effective treatment. If done correctly, it has a 92% success rate. If done incorrectly, it has a 100% failure rate. You know, you drink and die. So we try to carry this message. And the message is, AA works. And if you thoroughly follow these 12 steps, very rare that we have seen anyone fail. What is the definition of rare? And Ash can look this up in England. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, rarely used to be defined as seldom, comma, almost never, comma, one in a million. Wow! So if I do these steps thoroughly, only one out of a million will fail. If you have a second edition, or even if you read the foreword to the second edition, page Roman numeral XX of the book, it says, of alcoholics who came to AA and really tried, 50% stayed sober at once. This was 1950. 25% sobered up after some relapses. So you're talking about a 75% success rate, straight off the bat. And they said, of the other 25, who said, we like your meetings, we like your stories, but we don't like your program. Out of those, another 17%, 2 out of 3, returned and got sober. That's a 92% success rate, man. Any business would like to have that kind of 92% success rate. So, that is a message that these steps work. And to practice these principles in all our affairs. What are the principles we've been practicing through all the steps? It's been love. It's been tolerance. It's been humility. It's been honesty. It's been kindness. That's what we've been doing. It's been turning it over. There's more humility. It's been courage. It's been faith. That's what that. These are the principles, and we do them every day. So, why do I need to do this 12-step? I mean, I'm going for meetings, I'm talking to people, I'm listening to people, I have friends, I'm doing fellowship. Last night after the meeting got over at 10 or 10:15, we were fellowshipping till almost 1:30 in the night. I didn't wake up this morning, thank you very much. So, why do I need to do a 12 step? That's the question. So, let us go to page 89 of the big book, those of you that have the big book. Okay? And it says, very first paragraph, reading off the bat, biggest promise. Practical experience shows that nothing, underline nothing, will so much ensure immunity from drinking as much as intensive work with other alcoholics. So you see, Girish, someone else is saying that the voice is not audible. Is it my audio?
Voice seems to be very audible. Please make sure that the audio levels on your device are set to the maximum. Anish, are you able to hear clearly?
Very, very clearly. Loud.
Okay. So whoever can't hear clearly, you'll hear it clearly on the recording. Okay. So it says, ensures intensive work with other alcoholics. Okay. That's what they said. And in the forward to the second edition, on page XVII, on the top of the page, first line, it said, strenuous work, one alcoholic to another, is vital for permanent recovery, not temporary recovery, not partial recovery. Permanent recovery, strenuous work. When I do something strenuously, I sweat. And over here, on page 89, they are saying intense work. So who is supposed to do the sweating? Not the sponsee. The sponsor has to do the sweating. I'm the guy who has to be chasing the newcomer. I'm the fellow who's been taking, not, chal abhi my hero, here's my number, if you want to recover, call me. That's BS. Hi Mr. Newcomer, how are you doing? Listen, yeah, recovery is great, man. I'll be happy to help. Give me your number. I'll call you tomorrow morning. Come on, let me drop you home. I'm going that way. Practical experience shows that nothing will so much ensure immunity from drinking as much as intensive work with other alcoholics. I don't know if Ramesh was on this meeting tonight, but when Ramesh lived in Dubai and I lived in Sharjah, Ramesh, whatever his shift was, he only got Wednesday night off. So he got only one meeting a week. So on Wednesday night, we would both meet in Dubai at St. Mary's school. We'd attend the meeting from 8 to 9. Then we would go for dinner with my sponsor, Eric. So that would be like then fellowshipping after the meeting. By the time we reach dinner, 9:30. By the time we finish, 10:30, 11. And the only place we could go and sit was at the Dera taxi stand. And 11:30 at night, we were sitting at the Dera taxi stand doing big book, doing step work, however long it took. Whether it was, I don't know, Ramesh, we would sit for what, 2-3 hours sometimes, right? Maybe 12, 1. And then Ramesh, of course, had to only go locally home, lucky dog. But I had to take a share a cab and go to Sharjah along with some questionable people from other countries doing questionable professions over there. The noblest profession, the oldest profession. So, intensive work. And regardless of what time I reached home, I still had to be in the office at 8 o'clock the next morning. Even over here when we are doing these sessions, regardless of however late we have to be, there's still a whole lot of stuff I have to do. You know, I've got a couple of clients who have been on the phone with me. I've been doing online counseling with some of my clients. Plus, I'm running around getting stuff done for my neighbor downstairs who needs to be admitted to a hospital. Intensive work with others. And then they say, same paragraph, line 3, it works when other activities fail. It works when other activities fail. Wow. So when going to meetings, going to fellowship, gossiping about people, complaining to our wives, going to churches, going to movies, binge watching Netflix, then all these other things fail, intensive work with another alcoholic is what will work. Guaranteed. So they said, this is our 12th session. Carry this message to other alcoholics. And we've read 89 pages of the book so far. They haven't told us to go for meetings. They've just told us, get honest, admit you're an alcoholic, be willing to believe in a higher power, turn your will and thinking and thinking and life over, take an honest inventory, share it with your sponsor, give your defects to God, make amends as best as you can, take continuous inventory as well as morning and night prayer and meditation. That's what they've told us. This is what the message is. If any of you were at the 6 o'clock meeting today, where we were reading a vision for you, it was such a great experience, because you're looking at how Bill and Bob 12-step people, and we'll actually do that tomorrow. And the other guy's experience, what he was experiencing, in vision for you, they were telling us what they did. In Bill D's story, they were telling us what he experienced. It was really amazing. We saw both sides of the coin of the 12-step call. So they said, this is our 12th suggestion. Carry this message to other alcoholics. Why should I carry this? Because you, my dear fellow, who has recovered, look what they said, having had a spiritual awakening as the result of steps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You have had the spiritual awakening. You have had the personality change. You have recovered from a seemingly hopeless state of mind and body. You have been restored to sanity on page 84. You got your willpower back on page 85. You can trust your thinking on page 86. You can use it with assurance on page 87. Have recovered. So, last line. You can secure their confidence when others fail. Wow. You can secure their confidence when others fail. And life will take on new meaning. To watch other people recover. And this is where the fun starts. Okay? To watch other people recover, to see them help others, to watch loneliness vanish, to see a fellowship grow up around you, to have a host of friends. This is an experience you must not miss. We know you will not want to miss it. And frequent contact with newcomers and with each other is the bright spot of our lives. I can only tell you what my experience was. And my biggest joy was seeing Atul doing 12-stepping with people, seeing Anupam doing 12-stepping, seeing the number of people that I have had been blessed with the grace who have allowed me to show them the path of recovery. And to see them doing service, to see them working with others, man, this is the joy. This is the fellowship I am looking for. I go for AA meetings sometimes, I have no idea what they are talking about. They're going on and on about how they fell and complaining. I say, boss, there are solutions. Why are you being so angry? Pray for them. Look for your own. Can't break my head. I can't even be part of those conversations. There's no even solution in the conversation. It's only complain. I can't be in those meetings. I don't know. Those are like group depression meetings, you know, to me. I go over there and I come away depressed. Sometimes if I'm lucky, I'll find somebody who's recovered. And then it's a whole different ballgame, you know. So that's why I need to do a 12 step. Because I can do this message where no one else can. I have recovered. And number two, the rewards. Seeing other people doing this. Are wow. This is fantastic, man. This works. It is such fun. So how exactly am I supposed to take this message to someone? Or how am I supposed to sponsor someone? Then we come to the famous page 90 of the 12, of the step 12. So on page 90, how do I carry this message or sponsor someone? So the top line says, when you discover a prospect for Alcoholics Anonymous, find out all you can about him. Okay? Excuse me. What do I need to find out? So you come to the next paragraph, third line. And it says, get an idea of his behavior, his problems, his background, the seriousness of his condition, his religious leanings. You need this information to put yourself in his place, to see how you would like him to approach you if the tables were turned. And this brings to mind, a case we had in 93 or 94. I don't know the exact date. So I was sitting in the intergroup office and a Gujarati lady came in. You know, Ghagra, Chola, that traditional Gujarati dress. Crying, this, that, my husband is drinking, yevo and the other. So now preconceived notions. Asana, she's a Guju, husband must be Guju. Total preconceived motions. But the big book said, get an idea of behavior, problems, background, seriousness, condition, religious meanings, education, whatever. So I started asking her, ma'am, yeah, you want him to stop, but tell us a little bit about it. Then it turned out he was from my school. Then it turned out he was Maharashtrian, so it was a love marriage, Marathi Gujarati. He was from my school. He was a double graduate. He had a BA, BSA from Burani College and Maharashtra College. He was working as an accountant somewhere. He had lost his job. So now he was unemployed. He used to sit down the whole day playing cards, getting drunk. When he made money, he gave us some money to buy stuff. So now we got everything. So before I was saying, Guju, staying in some chawl, I'll send a couple of Marathi speaking members to the 12 step call. That was what I was thinking, whoever's closest living. Now when we heard what this guy's education, religious background was, the emotional thing, I said, this guy, for this to work, he has to be approached as an equal. If this guy's come from an English school and an English college, I don't want to send someone to go and talk to him in Marathi. Who the hell do you think I am? You know what we are like. So I called two other A members. One was in the Merchant Navy, one was the Indian Navy. Both were captains. And we had asked the wife, what time he goes to drink, and she said by 6 in the morning. And the next morning, 5:45 in the morning, we knocked on the door. Talk, open the door. You got a shock. Because these two guys were Navy uniform, I was in suit. We walked in, we said, the local wine shop has said that you are drinking too much. Whatever, we gave some funny story. And then we came in and started telling our stories. And this guy, he was a dental, he's saying, he's saying, you are, sir, the way you are talking, it sounds like my drinking, but are you log sad log hai yaar. Eventually he said, no, I want to come for the meeting. And that evening he went for the next first meeting. The next day he spoke at a meeting and he is still sober. He has not had a drink since. So this is what they said. You can succeed when others fail. Why? Because you have a solution. So find out everything about him. Because I was 12 step of my grandmother. Nobody ever paid a 12 step call on me. But if I was sitting on a 12 step, if I had to be 12 step, I would have liked somebody who I could relate to mentally, emotionally, preferably the same age group to have come and 12 step me. So these guys are very smart when they said, get an idea of his behavior, his problems and all that. You want to know how you would like to be approached if the tables were turned. How compassionate the authors of the big book were. Which brings us to the next question. What happens if he's not interested? What if the guy is not interested? Go back to the top of the page, second line. If he does not want to stop drinking, don't waste time trying to persuade him. You may spoil a later opportunity. Same page 90, at the bottom, last paragraph, first line. If he does not want to see you, never, N-E-V-E-R, underline, never force yourself upon him. And then if you jump forward to page 96, on page 96, it says, do not be discouraged if your prospect does not respond at once. He might respond after 90 days. Search out another alcoholic and try again. You are sure to find someone desperate enough to accept with eagerness what you have to offer. What do you have to offer? A solution. This solution. We find it a will not work with you. If you leave such a person alone, he may soon become convinced that he cannot recover by himself. And to spend too much time chasing one guy is to deny somebody else an opportunity to get sober and to be happy. So, why do I need a 12 step? How do I carry the message? And what happens if he's not interested? What happens if he is interested? What if he wants to stop? Then you go to page 91. And the summary of page 91 is tell your story. Now I'm going to read something very interesting. Because, and I make fun of this because I want to harass old timers. On page 91, third paragraph, see your man alone if possible. Now there are a lot of old timers that have not read the book. So there's a reason they call me Big Book Bastard. So I tell old timers, अरे तुम लोग क्या बोलते हैं नेवर गो अलोन ऑन अ 12 स्टेप कॉल. बिग बुक में लिखा है सी योर मैन अलोन इफ पॉसिबल. नाउ द ट्रूथ इज एबी थैचर वेंट अलोन टू सी बिल डब्ल्यू एंड बिल वॉज ड्रिंकिंग बट बिल वॉज ए चाइल्ड हुड फ्रेंड. द ट्रूथ इज बिल डब्ल्यू वेंट अलोन टू सी डॉक्टर बॉब बट ही वॉज अश्योर्ड दैट डॉक्टर बॉब वुड बी सोबर. बिग बुक सेज सी योर मैन अलोन. नाउ इफ यू हैव टेकन इट आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट. If you put it in context, it says when you go to the home to visit the alcoholic, then you see the man alone. Don't let the whole family be sitting over there while you're doing the 12-step call. Okay? But if you want to have fun, never alcohol. Arey, kabhi akela mat jao 12-step mein. Arey, in the big book it says see your man alone if possible. The truth of the matter is that many of us have had to do 12-step calls alone. Earlier this evening, Atul, sorry to break your anonymity, Atul, but earlier this evening, Atul was sharing an incident where he got a call, nobody was around, so he went, he did the 12-step call. The same situation I have been in, there have been times when people have, you know, called, there's been no one around, I have gone and done the 12-step call. My intentions are clear, I'm just trying to carry this message. I'm not going there to have a drink. So, when I'm seeing this guy alone, okay, what needs to happen? See a man alone, at first engage in some general conversation. After a while, turn the talk to some phase of drinking. Tell him enough about your drinking habits, symptoms and experiences to encourage him to speak about himself. So basically, you're telling your drunkologue, "Arey, I drank like this, I felt like that, I had accidents, I had divorces, I had bankruptcies, I lost jobs, enlarged liver, tat. Give him your story. Okay? And if you go down three or four lines, it says, give him a sketch of your drinking career up to the time you quit, but say nothing for the moment of how that was accomplished. So you say, hello sir, I'm Roy, how are you? I'm an alcoholic, this, that. Yeah, I drank like this, I felt like that, and now I'm sober 30 years. So thank you so much for giving me the time, and you start to leave. So you say, dude, hey, why are you telling me all this? Then on the last line, you commence to describe yourself as an alcoholic. So he's naturally going to say, what do you mean an alcoholic? Just now you told me you're 30 years sober. Don't tell him how you got sober. Don't tell him about AA. Don't tell him about rehabs. Don't tell him about anything. The big book says that. Give him a sketch of your drinking career up to the time you quit, but say nothing for the moment of how that was accomplished. Just describe yourself as an alcoholic. What do you mean? Why are you calling yourself an alcoholic? Just now you told me you're sober 30 years and now you're telling me you're an alcoholic. That's very contradictory. So then you turn the page, you go to page 92, and the summary of page 92, you have to explain the disease. You basically have to explain the doctor's opinion. You have to explain there is a solution, three types of drinkers. You have to explain two wives, four types of husbands. You have to explain more about alcoholism, the vague mental blank spots. This is what you have to do. And the big book says, tell him how baffled you were, top of the page. How you finally learned you were sick, doctor's opinion. Give him an account of the struggles you made to stop. Every Monday, chalo, never again, that's it. How many times you said, I'll only have two and you were not able to. Show him the mental twist which leads to the first drink of the spree. I'm sitting in the hospital. I've come out of a coma. I have 36 stitches in my head. My neck's in a collar. My back's in a prayer. And my mind says, have one drink, you'll feel better. That is a mental twist. That is insanity. So they say, tell him that. Give him an account of the struggles that you make to stop. Why can you do this? Go back to the bottom of the, and at the last paragraph it says, continue to speak as alcoholism as an illness, a fatal malady. Talk about the conditions of my body and mind which accompany it. My mind kept saying, I have only two. My body said, keep drinking. Why can you do that? Six lines from the bottom of page 92. You know why you can explain the disease? You may talk to him about the hopelessness of alcoholism because you offer a solution. I just told you my story. And I told him 30 years sober. I have a solution. Now I'm telling you why I drank. Dr. Silkworth explained it's a medical illness. It's a mental obsession. It's a physical allergy. Here are my examples of mental obsession. Here are my examples of physical allergy. And you share some examples with him. That's what you do. So now the guy's got a little curious. Okay, so you're an alcoholic. You drank like a fish. And now you had this bloody disease that you're telling me about. But how are you 30 years sober? How do you do it? So how do I explain the solution? So you come to page 93. Third line. Tell him exactly what happened to you. Stress the spiritual feature freely. He does not have to agree with your conception of God. The main thing is that he be willing to believe in a power greater than himself and live by spiritual faith. What are you saying? That's what it is. So when I was 12-stepping people, I was about 3-4 months sober. I was still willing to believe. I had not yet come to believe. So what did I say to him? I said, look, I was powerless. I tried to stop. I couldn't stop. Finally, when I came to AA, AA told me your own concept of a higher power. So I developed a concept, love, tolerance, forgiveness, kindness, second chances. This was my concept. Okay? Once I used that concept and finished the rest of the steps, my personality started to change. I became more patient. I became more tolerant. I became kinder some of the time, not all the time. So I did have that spiritual, and they said, Big Book says, stress it freely. First meeting only. Tell him, no, don't talk to him about God because he may not come. I heard an old timer say, I can't remember who it was. He said, look, don't worry about telling a newcomer about God. Because even if he runs away, the bottle will send him right back. Boss, the truth is page 25. That we have had deep and effective spiritual experiences. Personality changes. What is the point of me going to a new prospect? Yeah, I drank like this. The doctor says the disease and now I'm sober. How do you do it? I'll tell you that later how I did it. I went and met some guys. I listened to some stories. Very vague. There's nothing vague about recovery from alcoholism. Precise, exact, specific, clear, cut directions. These are just words from the book, by the way. Precise from the forward to the first edition, exact from the forward to the third edition, specific from page 18, clear cut from page 1. This is what they say. Clear cut, exact, specific, precise. That's what it is. No vagueness. Tell him exactly what happened to you. I came to believe, I'm willing to believe in some higher power. This group of, just one guy sober was my higher power. Because he was sober, I was not. Wow. So how do I explain the program? On page 94, line number 4, second paragraph. Look how simply they put it. Outline the program of action, explaining how you made a self-appraisal, how you straightened out your past, and why you're now endeavoring to be helpful to him. It's important for him to realize that your attempt to pass this on to him plays a vital part in your own recovery. Actually, he may be helping you much more than you are helping him. Make it plain, he's under no obligation to you. I only hope that when he escapes his own difficulties, he try to help other alcoholics. That's all. That's all I'm going to say, boss. Now, I can't say, tell him all the 12 steps, show him this page, show him how many columns. Outline the program of action. Okay, boss, so you're 30 years sober and you have all this medical disease, and you had a personality change. Again, how did this happen? Boss, I admitted defeat. Step 1. I asked for help. Don't say higher power, God. I asked for help. I took help. That's your higher power. I took a look at my life. Whom am I angry with? What am I afraid of? Whom have I hurt? Did a self-appraisal. I shared that with another alcoholic who's sober. I tried to the best of my ability to clean up my past. And now, my friend, thank you so much for listening to me so patiently. Because for me to stay sober one more day, my medicine, there's no pill, there's no short treatment. But for me to stay sober, I have to tell my story to somebody. So, sir, thank you so much for agreeing to see me. Thank you so much for listening to my story. I don't know if you will get sober or not. I hope you get sober. I hope you decide to try this. But thank you, sir. You have just saved my life. Thank you very much. You have helped me so much. This guy is getting angry when I'm in this son of a gun, you know. And the more he said, no, thank you. You can really have fun with people on a 12-step call. So I said, look, if you really want to get sober, then I hope when you're sober, you can help other people. So now what happens here on page 96? There are some people who say, wow, this is great. I want to start doing the step right away. Chalo, let's start right now. He's got a bottle in his hand, glass in his hand. Let's start right now. So on page 95, it says, one, two, three, fourth line. Sometimes a new man is anxious to proceed at once, and you may be tempted to let him do so. This is sometimes a mistake. If he has trouble later, he's likely to blame you. He say, you bloody made me do the steps. He's the guy who asked, come on, it's very good, I want to start the steps. It might be a mistake. So how exactly do I slow this guy down? How do I say, start the steps, but don't start the steps? AA was damn smart. They just put in the two paragraphs down. They said, if he is sincerely interested and wants to see you again, ask him to read this book in the interval. So give him one book. Carry one spare book in your car. So say, boss, before you start the steps, do me a favor. Take this book, just read it, cover to cover. Don't study it, read it. Ask him to read this book in the interval. After doing that, he must decide for himself whether he wants to go on. He should not be pushed or prodded by you, his wife, his husband, his boyfriend, his girlfriend, his children, or his friends. If he has to find God, he has to come from within. So, boss, here's your homework. You want to start the steps? Good. Here's your first job. Read this book. Sit up all night. Better than drinking. And if you can't sleep, big book will put you to sleep. So, suppose the guy calls you after 3-4 days. And he says, hey, Roy, I've read the book, man. Apun ready, hey. So, what happens on the next visit? Okay. So on the next visit, on page 96, second paragraph. Suppose you are now making your second visit to the man. You've gone to his house, or you met him for a second time at a meeting, or he has come to your house, you met at a coffee shop, or whatever it may be. Suppose you're now making your second visit. You ready? Two questions. John, have you read the book? John, are you ready to do the 12 steps? So he says, he has read this volume. Boss, I read the book. And says he is prepared to go through the 12 steps. Khalas. He's read the book. He says, I'm willing to do the steps. Now look what happens. It says, having had the experience yourself, which experience? Step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So having had the experience of the first 11 steps, you can give him much practical advice. About what? Stocks and shares, marriage proposals, real estate, car buying. No. You can give him much valuable advice about how to do the steps exactly as you did them. All you have to say, boss, I'm an alcoholic. The only thing I can do is to show you precisely how I did the steps. And congratulations, whoever stayed with us so far and has done the steps, you can now begin to sponsor people. It doesn't matter if you're 10 days sober, 10 years sober, 10 months sober. If you have done these 11 steps, you can start on the 12th step and start to sponsor people. Oh, what do I have to do? Please open worksheet number 1. So, Bidu, you read the book. You're ready to do the steps? Yes, please open to page 58. If you want what we have, and you're willing to go to any length, you're ready to take the step. Yes, I want what you have. So what do we have? What hope can I offer him about recovery? On page 15, Bill's story, we already went through that. The joy of living we really have. Families are reunited. People have come out of treatment centers, asylums, and have resumed a place in society. Businessmen have regained their standing. Scarcely any trouble or misery has not been overcome. This is what we have. This is the hope I can give him about recovery. Okay? Page 98. Burn the idea. Third paragraph. burn the idea into the consciousness of every man that he can get well regardless of anyone. Job or no job, wife or no wife, COVID or no COVID. The only condition is that you trust God, clean house. And those are your 12 steps, man. Trust God and clean house. Array, but what about all these people at meetings? Should I not be dependent upon them? Page 99, last line. Remind your prospect, and it's not sponsy, it's prospect. It's not kabutar, it's not bakra, it's prospect. Remind your prospect that his recovery is not dependent upon people. What? Sponsor or no sponsor? Sponsor can relapse, not dependent upon him. Your recovery is dependent upon your relationship with God. Whoa! This is amazing. This is total freedom, man. So my sponsor's phone is not working and I can't. Anyway, look what the big book says. Sex problems, don't ask your sponsor, ask God. Any other problem in life, don't ask your sponsor, ask God. Page 86, 87, you just saw that yesterday. So what? What is my job description now? Oh, 1 minute. Let's go before that. So, then is my sponsor going to abandon me if I have recovered? No. On page 100, second paragraph, addressed to the sponsor, it says both you and the new man must walk day by day in the path of spiritual progress. If you persist, remarkable things will follow. What are the promises I can get from the 12th step? Same paragraph. When we look back, we realize that the things which came to us when we placed ourselves in God's hands were better than anything we could have planned. You know, 30 years ago when I was 28 years old, if you told me, Roy, you're going to close your business, you will leave the film and television industry, you will go to the Arabian desert, you will go to the USA, You will actually go back to college, you'll study for 2 years. You'll be director of 3 rehabs in the US. You'll marry a Mexican, you'll have a son. You'll come back to India one day to start a center. If you told me all that 30 years ago, what are you saying? I'm just grateful I'm sober and I got one small naukri to do bloody with 2 bloody. That too doesn't even pay most of the time. But the 12 step promise. Things that came to us when we put ourselves in God's hands. Step 3, step 7, step 11, step 10. It's all thy will be done, thy will be done. Better than anything we could have planned. So what is my job description? So on page 102, 1, 2, 3 paragraph. Your job, see the word, now, not after 900 days. Your job now is to be at a place where you may be of maximum helpfulness to others. So never hesitate to go anywhere if you can be helpful. Never hesitate to go anywhere if you can be helpful. You should not hesitate to visit the most sordid spot on earth on such an errand. Keep on the firing line of life with these motives and God will keep you unharmed. And one night Ramesh and I were sitting at the Dera taxi stand. And we were doing our big book thing. Now we are sitting in Dubai. It's an Islamic country. And both of us are sitting and reading books with alcohol in it. And all of a sudden there was a roundup. And the mutawa and the religious police. And they were picking up all the drug dealers and the prostitutes. And just cleaning up everything. And then they came to us. We were both like crapping out of, oh my God. Apun to jaane wala hai. We are reading books about alcohol and the religious police on a roundup. What is this book you are reading? So I gave him my big book. Eh? I'm just saying, I hope he gives my bloody big book back here. All my notes and all are in it. So the guy opens the book, sees Alcohol Anonymous and all, and then he asks, what is this? So I told him, alcohol is haram, and this is a book on how to not drink alcohol. So we are both learning how to know haram and help other people. Dude, the guy just, he said, okay, you're doing good work, you guys. It is amazing. Ramesh, I don't know how. That is God here. Keep on the firing line of life with these motives and God will keep you unharmed. I have been in some fairly crazy situations. But I think that was one of the closest shares I ever had. I'll never forget that night. We were seeing all the hookers and all being taken off in handcuffs, the drug dealers, and we said, though, definitely gone, both of us. I don't know how much more scared Ramesh was than me. I was just pretending to be courageous and, you know, I'm the sponsor. I can't be afraid with the sponsor sitting there. Andar se toh phat raha tha mera. I was like, gone case. God will keep you unharmed. Arey, but what if I'm alone? You know, what if there's nobody over here? India is a vast country. The world is a vast place. Although we have AA in 183 countries and 77 languages, there's so many places where there's no AA. So what if I'm alone? What I can do? Please turn to page 162. It says, thus we grow. And so can you. Though you be one man with a book in your hand, we believe and hope it contains all you will need to begin. Page 162, Salah, and they're saying with this book you can begin. But they're saying, even if you're only one man, and even if you're only one man with this book in your hand, it's all you need. I can only tell you this has come true in my life. In 1991, when I got my copy of the big book, I mean, it's not that I was the only guy with the big book in Bombay, but I was using the big book and I was trying to help people through the big book and just being one guy with that big book, and then slowly there was a second, then a third, then a fourth, and there's so many people who have gotten into big book recovery and who went to 12. It is fantastic, yeah. It is just the joy of living. So now that I have done all this, should I continue to help others and should I continue to attend meetings? That's what I want to know, because I'm a selfish and self-centered alcoholic. So if you turn to page 181, 180 and 181 of Dr. Bob's Nightmare. So let us read what our co-founder Dr. Bob said about doing the 12 step and about going for meetings. He said, I spend a great deal of time passing on what I learned to others who want and need it badly. I do this for four reasons. Number one, it is a sense of duty. You know what? I have been given this solution. It is now my duty. I want to sleep. Yeah, I'm so tired today. I did one meeting from 6 to 7. I just want to sleep. But if I have this solution and I've been asked to speak, it is my duty to do this. Number two, it is a pleasure. It's a lot of fun. You guys are all my friends. I like hanging out with you. And the jokes that we share both after the meeting, between meetings, in between meetings. Girish will send some message. Anish will send something else. Atul will call out of the blue. Anupam will call out of the... We have... Ramesh just sent me another message which I haven't read about it. We have... Christopher will suddenly call at 1 in the morning and... It is Martin and Elvis today came all the way from Shirley to Veshmagul just to say hi and to give me some bibing cake and some pork sausage. Elvis, the cake was great. The sausage, I'll let you know. This is the joy of living. It's a pleasure, yeah. I go for you guys' weddings. Remember, Atul? And I go for your children's birthdays and I go for your parties. And this is what we do. It's a pleasure. Number three. In doing so, I am paying my debt to the man who took time to pass it on to me. And I'm very grateful to my first sponsor. He took the time to show me the set. No, it was not Big Book Recovery. But he took the time to sit with me and take me through the 12 steps. I'm very grateful to my second sponsor in Dubai, Eric. May he rest in peace. He said, boss, I'm not doing steps, FIPS. You want 10 steps? We can do that. You call if your head is up your ass, you call me, I'll pull it out. I'm very grateful to my third sponsor in New York, the late Billy F. He said, Roy, peace of mind is better than a piece of ass. So, let's get to the steps. We'll worry about the girlfriends later. Simple guy. Loved him. He got sober in 1969. And I'm very grateful to my fourth sponsor, Reggie, who's in New York right now. You know, I don't speak to him as often as I should. More than that, I'm very grateful to people like Atul, Anupam, Ramesh, guys like that, who at one point I was showing them how to do the steps, and now we are all sponsoring each other. Yeah, if I have a problem, I can call any one of them with a 10-step. Arey, yeah, this is what's happening. I'm full of fear, full of anxiety. I don't know what to do. I ask God. God is not giving me an answer. And we all laugh and joke, and Anupam say, why are you asking me? I am not God. I am not giving you the answer either. You know, if I call Anupam, Atul will say, sorry, wrong number, call Anupam. He is gone. So we have fun, yeah. It's a pleasure. And in by doing this 12-stepping and attending meetings and helping newcomers, I'm paying my debt to the person who took time to pass it on to me. And finally, every time I help others to go for a meeting, I take out a little more insurance for myself against a possible slip. Why? Because every time I go for a meeting, whether it's this meeting or whether it's some other meeting, invariably there'll be some new guy. He may be one day new, he may be 10 days new, maybe 10 weeks new, 10 months new. So, wow, I never knew the steps were so simple, I want to do them. And when I start hearing his story and the lost jobs and the fights at home and the money problems, health problems, I say, wow, alcoholism is alive and well. I have not had a drink for 30 years, but alcohol is still kicking people's backsides out there. Nothing has changed. Alcoholics are still getting into car crashes. They're getting into bankruptcy courts. They're getting into divorce courts. They're getting into hospitals. They're getting into jails. They're getting into rehabs. It's not changed. And even more heartbreaking, every time I go for a meeting, sometimes I see an old timer who has refused to do the steps. And they have slipped after time, 5, 10, 15, 20 years. And that is frightening because I see that alcoholism is alive and well. When we did the 10th step yesterday, it said, it is easy to let up on the spiritual program of action and rest on our laurels. We are headed for trouble if we do, for alcohol is a subtle foe. Subtle, it's sum comedy. Okay, it is waiting to just have a breather. Nothing will happen. It's not real alcohol. Have white wine. It's not strong like red wine. Or have light beer. It's light. No. Have non-alcoholic beer. Non-alcoholic beer also contains alcohol except for one brand. And on page 58, cunning, baffling, powerful, and patient. Alcohol waits. So every time I go for a meeting, it's a sense of duty. It's a pleasure. I'm paying back my debt to all my sponsors and I'm taking out insurance. Bach gaya yaar, it's still bloody hammering people. So, you cannot lead where you have not been. You cannot teach what you have not learned. You cannot be what you are not. If you have not completed the steps through this process, you cannot be a sponsor. Take out the word SP and put N over there. You can be a non-sir, not a sponsor. And you damn sure can't give what you haven't got. So we recover by the steps we take and not by the meetings we make. I want to thank Girish and Anish for giving me this opportunity to share my experience on step 12. And today we saw the how exactly the process. Page 89, we do the step because we have to stay sober. It's the best guarantee. Page 90, take out all the information about the new prospect. Page 91, tell your story. Page 92, explain the disease. Page 93, explain the spiritual solution, personality change. Page 94, outline the program of action simply and thank him for saving your life. Page 95, give him homework. Give him a book and say, read this. Page 96, if he's read the book and willing to do the steps, start doing sponsorship. Page 98, 99, your recovery is not dependent on any human being. Only on God and your relationship with God and you're doing the 12 steps. Is your sponsor to abandon you? No. Page 100, your sponsor will now walk shoulder to shoulder. Before he was in front of you, giving you a hand, pulling you up the path. Now you're on a broad highway, so you can both walk side by side. And finally, you have a job description to go anywhere and help people. And God will keep you safe if you are going with these motives. And the four reasons for going for meetings: sense of duty, pleasure, paying back a debt, and insurance. So thanks very much. Sorry I ate up almost the whole hour. Thank you.